Zombies is the only game mode that has yet to be released in Call of Duty Mobile. Just the other day, it was Halloween, the spookiest day of the year, so it would have made perfect sense for Zombies to come out then, but nope. Call of Duty Mobile still hasn't given us any new information on Zombies. So in today's video, I'm going to be covering a bunch of unique leaks. The leaks include all of the maps coming at launch, 5 different Zombies game modes, weapon abilities, pack-a-punching, and all of the unique perks that are coming to the game. If you're excited for Zombies to come to Call of Duty Mobile, leave a like down below, subscribe to the channel if you have not already, and remember to turn on notifications because over these next few weeks, there's going to be loads and loads of new information regarding Zombies, leaks, multiplayer. So if you want to be up to date with the latest leaks and news regarding Call of Duty Mobile, make sure you're subbed with notifications on. One thing before we get started, the background gameplay is from a YouTuber named Ray Legardo, so full credit goes to him, and a lot of the information in this video was from another YouTuber named The Gaming Revolution, so I want to give a massive shout out to him as well. Getting on with things though, when you're at the main menu of Call of Duty Mobile, you'll notice that the Zombies tab is no longer locked. And when you click on this game mode, it's going to take you on over to the Zombies main menu. On the far right side, we have 4 different levels of difficulty. We have easy, regular, hard, and then the most difficult being hell. Underneath the difficulties, we have the map selection. So far, there have been a few maps leaked, but I believe that all of the maps I'm about to mention aren't going to be released at the launch of Zombies. So the maps that are 100% coming when Zombies is first released is Transit. Now, Transit is an absolutely huge Zombies map. There's a bus you have to take to get from location to location, and since this map is so big, Transit is split up into many different maps. So you can choose to play the big Transit map on its own with the bus, or you can play the unique smaller maps of it, which include Farm, Town, Diner, Bus Depot, Cornfields, and then there's many other mini maps on top of that. So everything I just mentioned there is gonna be a map that comes out when Zombies is first released. And then I have 2 other maps that are gonna be coming in the future, but at the moment, there's no set date in mind. So the other 2 maps are Shinonuma, which is essentially a giant swamp, and then the final map, Nocturne Totem, which was the very first map ever released in Zombies history. Now with all of these maps, there's gonna be 5 game modes to choose from. We have missions, challenges, strikes, raids, and survival. In the background gameplay, I believe this is the mission game mode, but I'm not 100% sure on that. So survival is the easiest game mode to explain first off. This is pretty much you spawn in and you survive as long as you can. As far as the other 4 game modes go, I believe they just give you a task and you have to complete it. Some may have you reach a certain round, others may have you defeat a boss, and whenever you complete a mission, you get new unlocks. So unlocks will include perks, attachments, etc. And there are tons and tons of missions to go through. Like this clip right here was from The Gaming Revolution, and just look at all these maps available to complete. I believe this was filmed before the beta of Call of Duty Mobile, so keep in mind, this was months and months ago. So when Zombies comes out, I bet you it'll be a lot more fine-tuned and there's going to be way more on top of this. Moving on to the Zombies loadout, we have our primary and secondary weapon, our character, and then we have 9 perks total, 3 for attack, 3 for defense, and 3 for ability. With our primary weapons, you pretty much get to choose whatever and you can select your attachments, but you're going to notice on the bottom, there's 2 tabs. One of the tabs says ability and the other says intensify. So when you select this ability button, it pretty much gives your weapon buffs. One of them looks like bullet penetration. This one looks like you pull your weapon up faster after running. And then the 3rd ability we get to see is reload speed. I'm not sure if there's going to be more abilities than just these 3. And one thing I want to point out, when you're looking at the perks, the final 3 perks are ability. So I'm not too sure if those perks are related to your weapon skills or if these are going to be actual perks. And then the other tab next to ability is intensify. And I believe this is just pack-a-punching your weapon. Whenever you pack-a-punch your weapon, it makes it incredibly stronger. One thing The Gaming Revolution pointed out is in order to pack-a-punch your weapon, it costs COD points, and he was thinking that this may be pay-to-win because there's other elements of Zombies that seem pay-to-win as well, and I'll cover those when we get to them. Moving on over to your character selection, you pretty much get to choose what your guy looks like. All of the soldiers you have unlocked in multiplayer in Battle Royale, all of those will be accessible here. Now moving on over to the perks, I'm just going to be reading you a bunch of different perks that I have screenshots of. Now as I stated, there's three different categories for perks. There's attack, defense, and ability. So I'm not too sure which categories these fall under, but just knowing the names is pretty cool regardless. So the first one we have is double tap, and this is going to give us two bullets for the price of one. So whenever you shoot one bullet, it's going to shoot two. The next perk is juggernaut, and this essentially gives you more hit points. So whenever a zombie hits you, it'll take more hits until you go down. And I do want to point out there's multiple rarities for perks. So the green and purple rarity here, it says you get it from crafting. I'm assuming there's going to be a workbench on the zombies map and you have to build the perk somehow. The common rarity, it says you unlock from doing missions. We already discussed that when you complete missions, it gives you different attachments, perks, abilities, etc. And then the legendary perk here, it says you get it from the store. So I'm not sure if you're going to have to use COD points to unlock this or the other currency, but that brings up the question again, is this going to be pay to win? Moving on over to the next set of perks, first up we have electric cherry. This makes it so you electrocute zombies whenever you reload. After that we have fleet foot, which is going to let you run faster. Next up we have gecko, and I'm not too sure what this does. I have two ideas in mind. The first one is that you recover your health faster after being hit. And the second one would be that this is similar to quick revive, so you can revive teammates quicker when they go down. And now the final two perks are buffed and heroic, and both of these show a knife-like icon. I was thinking this buffed perk gave you increased melee damage, but looking at heroic, it literally looks the same thing, so maybe this is increased melee damage as well. Since this buff perk shows an arrow, maybe this is faster weapon swap speed, but again, they both show knives, so I'm thinking both are increased melee damage. And one thing I do want to backtrack to just a little bit to be more clear here. When I showed you the main menu, remember there's three categories for perks: attack, defense, and ability. And then I showed you the weapon abilities as well. So I really don't know if these weapon abilities are counted as a perk or if they kind of just stick to the weapon and we have even more perks for this ability section. Now, that is all the information that I have for today's video. If you enjoyed these leaks or learned something new, remember to leave a like down below. And if you're not already subscribed to the channel, hit that subscription button and turn on notifications to never miss an upload. As I said, Zombies isn't out yet, and there's going to be a lot more leaks coming out over these next few weeks until Zombies is officially released. So if you'd like to stay up to date with the latest news and leaks related to Call of Duty Mobile, make sure you're subscribed to the channel. So guys, this has been Eclipse. Thank you for watching today's video, and peace out.